dramatic changes in Over the Rhine right now, prompting once wary home shoppers and business owners to take a second look now. And tonight, Target 5's Dave Wagner explores the revival of Over the Rhine.
It is a neighborhood shrouded in both infamy and history.
We have the largest amount of Italianate architecture in the country.
A place where drug deals often overshadow real estate deals.
It's almost like the new frontier because there's so much opportunity down here because there's so much need.
A neighborhood that elicits both pride and prejudice.
I just think it's really important that people know that there is something of value here.
If you venture to Vine Street and over the Rhine, you'll find yourself in the middle of a renaissance. Bill Baum has been renovating buildings in Over the Rhine for 23 years. At 12th and Vine, he's taken an empty furniture warehouse and converted it to luxury condominiums.
Buildings that, you know, 150, 200 years old, a lot of character, high ceilings.
Original hardwood floors, granite countertops, luxury appliances, and large bathrooms. Across the street, the newly renovated Dunkins and Lofts. 25 market-rate condominiums.
A lot of young, professional people who I think want just the opposite of that, you know, sort of typical house in the suburbs. They want to be where things are happening and near the arts and downtown.
With prices ranging from $70,000 to more than $350,000, people are buying.
We're selling good. I mean, our year target was about 30 units. We're up to 40. In 1 year.
On what used to be a corner filled with crime, Chef Jean-Robert Descavelles is building a new restaurant. Stores like Micah 12V are targeting high-end shoppers.
Restaurants, grocery stores, new retail venues, the more the merrier.
Lisa Yunker saw an opportunity and opened a garden store at 12th and Vine.
I'm a single mom and I pretty much, the buck stops here. So I don't have time to just be playing around at this. This is my livelihood. And I would be looking for an exit strategy like right now if I weren't totally confident.
While the rebirth continues, there are some in Over the Rhine who fear they're losing their neighborhood.
Do you feel low-income people are being pushed out of Over the Rhine?
Definitely, definitely.
Cassandra Barham is with the Contact Center, a nonprofit organization that for 40 years has been dealing with poverty issues in Over the Rhine.
The biggest concern that I have is actually our families coming back to Over the Rhine. Our children being able to go to school. Our children being able to walk to the parks and enjoy themselves.
The city has torn down the neighborhood school to make way for a renovated Washington Park, a place that many homeless people call home.
I need a quarter.
And there's talk of closing the neighborhood pool.
I think it's about time they cleaned up Washington Park.
Mary Goolsby lives with her 2-year-old son, Jalen, in Over the Rhine. She welcomes the new development, but says her income at a fast food restaurant isn't enough to live in one of the renovated buildings.
Most of the people that live down here can't afford marketed rent.
Protecting longtime residents is the mission of Mary Burke and the Over the Rhine Community Housing Network. She's been working with the city and developer 3CDC to offer affordable housing in Over the Rhine.
It's always exciting to see buildings getting renovated. We just want to make sure that the residents who have lived here for a long time aren't harmed by it and can really benefit from it.
In the heart of Vine Street development, the renovated Recovery Hotel offers housing for homeless in recovery.
I'm not against the change, you know, I'm not.
Mike Rogers went from getting a degree in business administration at Ohio University to working at General Motors to being homeless on the streets of Over the Rhine. He's gone from being poor to helping the poor maintain a place in Cincinnati's oldest neighborhood.
I think that we can have a mixed community of diversity, so to speak, and that we can all appreciate and love one another, because at the end of the day, we're just human beings.
It's amazing to see the changes in Over the Rhine. It's also a safer place than it once was. Over the past 2 years, with an intense presence from Cincinnati police and sheriff's deputies, serious crime in Over the Rhine has dropped in every category. Dave Wagner, Target 5.